is a man who's going to give the city a run for the money.
I knew exactly how it was going to start.
Yeah, but do you know how it's going to end? One. Bring
this lightning, you're burning up the quarter of mine.
I say we were done.
Nice. This is just a preview of good things yet to come.
He's one of Hollywood's coolest customers, and he has a successful movie career spanning 35 years. So whether it's burning up the dance floor or holding a gun to your head, few do it as well as my guest today, who's flown in all the way from Florida. It gives me great pleasure to welcome the very cool, the very stylish John Travolta. John, thank you so much for joining us on the show today.
Well, thank you for having
me. It's been a long flight, hasn't it?
It has, but I'm here now.
Yes. You flew yourself in?
I did. Took two segments.
Okay.
And I feel good.
Okay.
So I'm ready.
Is that the longest journey you've done?
No. No.
Ah.
I've done from Europe, Rome to Australia. That was my longest journey.
That does sound long.
But Florida to India is pretty far.
It is.
Yeah, it's a good distance.
Okay. Now, you know, your love for flying is well known. Is that the most liberating experience one can have?
Well, it's one of them.
Okay.
Yes, it's very extroverting, and I get a thrill that never stops. I can, every time I go up, I enjoy it.
Okay. You're a brand ambassador for Breitling watches.
Yes.
How does Breitling's aviation functions help you when you're in the pilot seat?
Well, there are many watches,
mm-hmm.
and they have various functions. And the Navitimer is the one that I wear.
Mm.
I'm going to a fancy event tonight, so I'm wearing a different Breitling.
Okay.
But the Breitling I advertise in the photographs is a Navitimer, and that gives you some flying assistance if you need it. And various pilots have various ideas of what they need.
Sure.
So.
Okay. You're here, of course, to receive your first GQ award.
Yep.
Do you have special feelings about this? How does it feel?
Well, I love GQ. I mean, that's men have very little they can do to celebrate their appearance, and a suit and a watch are two of the few things they can do with a few casual outfits. So, I think it's nice when men are acknowledged for style.
Yes.
And for fashion, because we have so little that we can actually, women have it cornered, and so the little bit that we can do to look better,
sure,
for the women is nice.
So what's your idea of style?
Well, style is individual.
Mm.
I think style has a lot to do with symmetry, meaning balancing one's appearance.
True.
With what they look. So I think if someone's smart, they go with what looks best on them. And they choose the colors that look best on them. And it varies for each person. So style is a very individual thing.
Sure.
Yeah.
Now, from the cover of the November issue of GQ India, what can one expect?
It's more or less an Indian feeling with Nehru style jackets, which actually are very hip right now. I mean, when I was a kid, they were the style in the late 60s, but they've come back now.
Right.
And so every major designer has at least one or two Nehru options. And I even have some in my closet, which I love. I think they're very classic and good looking.
Okay. Now, you're going to be introduced to several Bollywood stars at the GQ Awards tonight. Are you familiar with any of them?
Yes. The man I'm giving the award to, Amir Khan, is a wonderful actor and a very stylish man himself. And I look forward to giving you him that award. Yeah.
Sure. Now, are you familiar, John, with Indian cinema at all? You know, you've been a very successful musical star.
Sure.
Are you appreciative of the Bollywood musical genre?
Oh, sure, because I'm a rare bird in Hollywood. I sing and dance, and
right,
not many of us do. You know, Barbra Streisand and Shirley MacLaine and myself and Liza Minnelli. I mean, we're like four of the only dinosaurs left that actually do these things. So I fit more in with Bollywood than I even do in Hollywood. But the good news is that when I do it, it's always a big success, and I have the pride of having the two biggest musicals in history. So, I like it. It's rarefied, but I'd like to do it more, and I don't get a chance to because it's a minority genre, really.
Mm. So any chance then we could see you doing a Bollywood musical, a Bollywood film?
Well, if one were offered to me, I guess I could...
Surely there's been interest over the years.
No, I have never been presented a Bollywood musical.
Okay.
But that doesn't mean it won't happen.
Yeah, that's something to tell the producers then.
Yes.
Now, John, you began your career with Grease as the 16-year-old star of the Broadway musical. And then in 1978, you did the movie version. Mm-hmm. Grease was also re-released this year as a sing-along version.
Yeah, which was marvelous.
Is that the film closest to your heart?
Well, it's one that I grew up having very close to my heart because I always wanted to do the movie.
Right.
But moreover, it's entertained people over 3 decades.
Shooting Grease?
Oh, they're glorious. I mean, I had a terrible crush on Olivia Newton-John, and I got to sing and dance every day, and that was glorious and fun and right up my alley.
Okay.
And the crew was great, and I think we knew that we had something.
Right. Now, Grease is regarded as the definitive high school movie. In fact, Disney's high school movies seem too sanitized and, unlike Grease,
sure,
which had its, the teenage pregnancies, it had raging hormones.
Yep.
Do you feel like the American teenager is very different from the one we saw in Grease?
Well, I don't know if they are, but the entertainment value of the kind of musical that parallels Grease is quite different. I think we were more adult-oriented.
Right.
We kind of did a musical that appealed to the adults as well as the children. Mm. And I think the newer ones mostly appeal to young people, not even, mostly lower teenager-type audience, which is perfectly valid.
Sure.
It's just that it's a smaller type of audience than Grease had, let's say.
Right. Okay, on that note, let's take a short break. We'll be back with John Travolta in just a few minutes. Came to you at a time when your career was at a low phase.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know while making that movie that it's going to be this film that's going to be special?
I thought it would be special and that it would be the equivalent of an art film, but I did not know that it would be a worldwide mega hit.
You famously danced with Princess Diana in the White House many years ago.
Yes.
Can you recount that memory for us? You're among that rare breed of actors who's just as comfortable playing negative roles. Is there a dark side to you?